All right. Now, when you have a commercial lien on the public record and you know who you are, you can create your own money. And it don't matter what it looks like. And but it does help to have some type of for the sake of people, the majority of the people on the earth, that still need to learn this stuff. You can just use your local checks. Your name printed at the top left-hand corner of the check is the grantor. When you sign at the bottom of the right-hand side of the check, you are the trustee. And you take that check and you flip it the page like a book. And the last part of the page is in the lower right-hand corner of the check. Just like on the front of the check, the end of the page is the right-hand corner. The top of the page where you start writing is the left-hand corner. Everybody starts writing left to right, all the way down the page till you get to the end of the page. That's the end of the page. Flip the page, same thing. You get to the lower right-hand corner. There's where the beneficiary is, and that's you also. You are the backing of all paper money. You are the trustee. That means you get to make the decision when that paper money gets distributed and how it gets distributed. And you are also the beneficiary. So, you're the creator. You decide when it gets to how it gets distributed. And you distribute it to yourself. You are the three in one. You are a trust. That's a private trust. That is also known as your own customized private promissory notes that are easy to make and they're already printed up in the form of what's called checks. Simple as that. When you turn that check over and you put your beneficiary signature on it, and you can put your all capitalized name under it also, and if you need to, you can write beneficiary. And you can put without prejudice, which means that you are not being prejudged in the eyes of the public attorney as a citizen slave. And you can put under duress, which means that the only way to get your remedy is you're being forced under duress to have to create these paper monies. Otherwise, you could just go to the shelf, show them your public lien right there in front of them, and they should have an attorney there at the cash register at all times to say, "Yep, that's an authentic lien. Free, free, free." That's the simple way of doing it. And that's what's going to happen. Believe me, it's going to manifest. You're going to have a public attorney sitting there at the cash register, and all you got to do is show them your public lien. And he'll say, "Free, free, free." Simple as that. Now, when you write these what's called promissory notes, or I just call them trust checks, and the bank dishonors or the company dishonors your check by refusing it, you have them write on a piece, separate piece of paper that says they refused it. And if they don't write on paper for you, you send them an affidavit of truth and say, I gave you this trust check, which is good, by way of my commercial lien. I'm creating my own paper money. You're refusing it. And when they don't respond to your affidavit of truth that you send to them by registered mail or certified mail, in other words, they're going to acquiesce because they know you're right. So when they dishonor you, you send a copy of the check and a copy of the dishonored affidavit, the agreement that they acquiesce to. Give them 3 days. Natural law takes the sun, stops for 3 days before it changes positions. That's where that was patterned after. And you can also send them an affidavit of default, just as a security measure, which is basically just says, well, I gave you 3 days to answer. You haven't answered. So here's your affidavit of default. Default just means automatic judgment. Boom. Seems like you've already agreed to this affidavit that you refuse to accept my trust promissory note that I created in my own custom fashion way. Seems like you did not respond. And non-response is acquiescence. That is now judgment. This is now the court judgment on paper. Default judgment. It ain't no different when the court sends you papers to come to court and you don't show up. The attorney automatically says to the judge, I want default judgment. He's guilty. It's the same thing. Your affidavits are the court. Your affidavits are the judgment. And you can take that judgment and send it to the international military. And your nearest representative of the international military or the world court is the IRS, called CID, the Criminal Investigation Department. They are your nearest relative with the gun. And the CID will ensure that your custom promissory note gets honored. You send them a copy of your lien if you have to, or the website. You send them all the evidence, and they're just waiting for you to send it to them. And if you want to be safe, accept your birth certificate for value and write you a set-off bond. Put that in the public record. And you can use Facebook as your public record if you want. Or you can use the Secretary of State, known as a UCC-1 financing statement. Any record is good public record. You can post it on your house, on your car. You can tattoo it on your back. You can mail yourself through the mail if you want to with your affidavits. Now, if you don't understand any of this, you need to do a YouTube search on solutions in commerce and listen to Winston Shrout teach you. Because people have put fragments of his videos on the YouTube. Sometimes you'll get full seminars. But that's just to give you a taste to wake you up so that you can call the office and tell them you only got so much money, and they will work with you and send you DVDs and seminars so you can do your own self-study. And these DVDs and seminars will have templates and recommended reading materials, as well as other reading materials already included that you can study and learn how to get it done and have some understanding. But basically all it is rebut the assumption with a security agreement and a commercial lien. Some people call it becoming a secured party creditor. Then you can write your own promissory notes, and you send these promissory notes either to the corporations, and if they refuse to accept it, well, you get their agreement that they're refusing it. And that can be done. They can write it on a paper right there in front of you. Or if they refuse to give you a paper, you send them an affidavit, and they will acquiesce. Now, you take a copy of that check that they refused, and a copy of the affidavit that they agreed to, that they did refuse your check, your trust check, your custom promissory note, because you're the creator, you can write your own money, and you can color it purple or pink if you want. And you can draw naked ladies on the front of it if you want. It's yours. You are the creator of your reality. You're the king, you're the judge, you're the court. You hold all the power. Didn't you know that? Rise up! And roar like a lion and play that Katy Perry song about 45 times today. Because they're going to hear you roar. And they are going to hear us roar. You send all the copies of that stuff. Your lien, your security agreement, your check, your custom check, and their agreement that they refused to accept it. You send it to the international military representative known as IRS, Criminal Investigation Department, otherwise known as CID. And they will cause that corporation to honor your custom check as king of your body. They are the mercenary between two people in trade. When you go to the shelf to buy bread off the shelf, they got something to trade, you got something to trade. They want money. And they're telling you your money is no good when it is good. Because all money is created from the birth certificate application bond, which you just put your lien on. Remember, the corporation assumes jurisdiction over that corporate birth certificate application bond. And when they have assumption of jurisdiction, when they print money up from that bond that's backed by your labor, if they have the assumption of jurisdiction and you agree with them that they can have jurisdiction over you, then they're going to tell you, you have to use our paper money to pay for goods. And we're going to write our own pictures on our own paper money, and you use this. And we're going to put our pyramids and naked ladies on it, and you use this. And if you fall under their jurisdiction, instead of rebut the assumption with a security agreement and a commercial lien and post it on the public record, till such time as you do these things, they're going to rule you with a big gun. And the reason why they're ruling you with a big gun under the assumption of jurisdiction is because Mother Nature authorized them to do it, to teach you a lesson. Because you were killing each other out in the jungle. So she put you in Prison Planet. Under the rules of an assumptive jurisdiction of a public attorney to make sure you get rehabilitated. And when you've proven yourself worthy before Father Cause and Mother Nature, then you can sign yourself out and create your own world, babies. This is Prince Russell, King of the Earth, signing out.